Hello friends, welcome to the daily current affairs session for the prelims brought to you by Ekam IAS. Today on the 22nd April, we are going to have some topics on Defence Planning Committee, Rashtriya Gram Swaraj Abhiyan, Project Samarthan, Tirupati Varaha, Earth Overshoot Day and Trade Related Entrepreneurship Development Assistance Scheme or TREAD Scheme, TREAD, TREAD Scheme. So let's have a detailed look. Defence Planning Committee, now we have already seen about Defence Acquisition Council, which is for the procurement of defence various components, including aircrafts, technologies, arms, you know, the jackets, the life jackets, the helmets, etc. So anything procuring by the defence will be, you know, recommended by Defence Acquisition Council, headed by various secretaries and ministers of very high level, and that was constituted last year. So similar to that, recently the government also set up a Defence Planning Committee. Now, Defence Planning Committee is concentrating on an overall, a comprehensive planning strategy making to have our defence, you know, to optimize our defence expenditure, to have a good budget, to utilize a good that budget allocated each year to, you know, everything that relate to A to Z of a defence planning. So that is what Defence Planning Committee. Now, this will be headed by our National Security Advisor. Don't put the answer on PM or Defence Minister or anyone else. So it will be headed by National Security Advisor. Actually, while the Constitution, while constituting this DPC or Defence Planning Committee, the guideline was to have an ex officio chairman as the Chief of Defence Staff. Chief of Defence Staff, actually, that was a post to be created during 2001 when Atal Bihari Vajpayee, he had this idea of creating a new post above this all the Army, Navy and Air Force Chief. Together, they will have a head that is called a Chief of Defence Staff. So, this Chief of Defence Staff or CDS will have more power than all the three staffs of different services. So, that decision is still pending in the Lok Sabha and the Parliament. It has not been approved. But so, during the constitution of this DPC, the ex-officio chairman to be headed was actually CDS or the Chief of Defence Staff. But for the time being, we don't have that post. So, National Security Advisor will assume the charge of a CDS and will head or chair the this committee. So, it will have members of, you know, all the three defence staffs. All the three defence chiefs, Bipin Rawat, Dhanoa and the Air Force and Navy. So, who is it? Lamba. So, three service chiefs will be there, secretaries of Ministry of Defence, all the high level secretaries, and expenditure and foreign affairs secretaries also will be there as its member, because it is a planning committee, it will need finance, so it will be a collaboration with defence and finance and external affairs. So, external affairs is also there in this committee. So it's a multimodal, it's a collaborative, it's an interactive committee to plan the defense strategies, to build a national security plan for India. So anyway, well, let's read it. It's a new committee to improve higher defense management. Simply, DPC will be a permanent body chaired by National Security Advisor. Aims, what are the aims? Draft national security strategy, capability development plan, defense diplomacy issues. So it will also cover diplomacy issues. That is why external ministry members will be also there in this committee. Defense manufacturing in India. So it covers everything. So DAC, just like the Defense Acquisition Council, we also have a Defense Planning Committee. So same way. And it is presently the charge, the chairmanship is actually the ex-officio chairman should be the CDS or the Chief of Defense. But this is presently assumed by National Security Advisor Ajit Doval. So, and following other members. So, next news is about Rashtriya Gram Swaraj Abhiyan. Now, this is actually a revamped or modified version of Rajiv Gandhi Panchayat Sashaktikaran Abhiyan, which was actually an initiative by the previous UPA government. So, this is a revamped version. And recently, what it is, the news is that the Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs approved a restructured or a revamped or revived Rashtriya Gram Swaraj Abhiyan. What is the aim? Its aim is to building infrastructure and e-governance. Always, that is the main aim or umbrella aim. E-governance and better capacity infrastructure, building infrastructure. So this comes under the e-panchayat mission mode project. Actually, in India, we have this e-panchayat initiative or e-panchayat mission mode initiative. to make all the panchayats in India, all the panchayats in every states, wherever there are panchayats. Now, there are states without panchayat also. That is called non-part 9 areas, where we have the Schedule 6. Schedule 6 are having, they don't have panchayat actually, they have different councils for especially concentrating on the tribal areas. So, wherever there are panchayats, government is trying to make it as an e-panchayat, a digital panchayat, where there will be a faceless, paperless work, everything will be computerized and etc. So, that is e-panchayat mission mode project. Now, it extends to all the states, all the UTs, institutions of rural government in non-part areas, non-part 9 areas are the Schedule 6 states. Schedule 6, there are 4 states, Assam, Tripura, Manipur and Arunachal Pradesh. So, Schedule 6 states have, similar to Panchayat, they are having whatever the local governing bodies, tribal districts are there, tribal councils are there, etc. So, all those including those institutions plus any rural government self-government bodies, everything coming under the states and UTs. So, every institutions under this rural or the last mile, the self-government will be made to a digital one. So, e-panchayat. So, that is what e-panchayat means. So, if a statement comes, only panchayats are there or the institutions of non-part 9 areas are not there like that. So, have a good knowledge about that. So, sharing will be between states and center will be 60-40 ratio. And one more thing, ActionSoft is a mobile application. See, ActionSoft is a mobile application, not a software, it's a mobile application, not a computer version. It is for the tracking of the progress of panchayat works. We have many schemes that are being implemented through panchayats. Many centrally sponsored schemes, many central sector schemes are there, which are to be implemented through panchayats. Which will be, some will be center, some will be state government initiatives, etc. Some will be centrally sponsored scheme. So, everything, many are there which should be implemented through panchayat, and that work which are being carried out by panchayat under the scheme should be monitored, should have a tracking of progress. So, that is done by this ActionSoft mobile application. Now, that will have geographical, it will record the geographical coordinates and send photos of the progress of the work so that the higher officials can have a good knowledge of the progress of implementation. That is how we say rural electrification program phase 1 is completed, phase 2 is being carried out, the target is 2020, like that. Every scheme will have phases and there will be target, there will be a halfway target, like the project will be up to 2020. So, what is the progress in 2018, like that. So, that is done through such kind of softwares and mobile applications, particularly for panchayat. We have ActionSoft. We will learn other applications also when that kind of news comes by. Okay. So anyway, just have a glance. There are various schemes of central sponsored, centrally sponsored scheme which are implemented through panchayat, like MNREGA is there, Indira Avas Yojana, total sanitation campaign under the Swachh Bharat Mission also implemented through panchayat. This accelerated rural water supply program, that is also implemented through panchayat. Midday meals. See, midday meals is a initiative under the MHRD, Ministry of Rural, Ministry of Human Resource Development. But that is being implemented through panchayats. Micro irrigation is there, National Horticulture. So, many schemes are there, many centrally sponsored schemes are there, which are being implemented through panchayats. So, don't mistake this. Have a good knowledge. Just refer the site of Ministry of Panchayat Raj. It has many lots of initiatives talking about. Project Samarthan. See, we have one project called Project Samadhan. Project Samadhan, that is particularly concentrating on the left-wing extreme state to have an anti-Naxal, to give awareness to the people who were part of this Naxalites group and etc., left-wing extremist group, etc., to give them education, give them awareness, to tell them peace and all those activities to take them or drag them into the entrepreneurs and innovative skill training, etc., and have a self-employment. So, that kind of an initiative is Project Samadha. Now, this is different. This is Samarthan. Samarthan is there is a program of World Health Organizations called Psychological First Aid. Psychological First Aid, PFA. It's a program under this WHO, World Health Organization. That is to give this first aid to the mentally unstable inmates of the prison who who went through many drastic situations which led to the crime. That is why they are in the prison. So that kind of people will be concentrated, and this medical aid will be given by whom? By the staff members of the particular prison. So that person, the staff of that prison will be trained to give medical assistance like first aid and CPR and all those things, like anything which is a medical assistance, which will be, so that person who gives that medical assistance will be trained by different persons, different like professors of AIIMS and other medical personnel, the doctors, nurses, etc. So anyway, let's have the news is that Tihar jail is to adopt the World Health Organization's psychological first aid, PFA. So Tihar jail is going to adopt this PFA of World Health Organization. So that initiative or that scheme is called Project Samarthan. So Project Samarthan is related to Tihar jail, which is related to WHO's PFA, which is psychological first aid. Now what it is, it will enable the inmates of the prison who suffer from mental health issues to avail expert medical assistance. Now, why mental issues? Because many prisoners will be there who had drastic conditions or drastic situations which led to the crime, which led to their imprisonment. So that is why, to give them medical assistance. Now, who will give the medical assistance? Prison staffs. Now, who will train the medical this prison staffs? Under this, they will be under the guidelines of the psychiatry professor of AIIMS, all in the Institute of Medical Science, plus in collaboration with Mental Health Foundation, is an NGO, plus any medical professional like doctors and nurses and senior nurses, etc., plus prison staffs, so who have experience in this. So that is what it will be done by prison staffs, not any external one. So PFA, again I'm repeating, it's a WHO initiative to provide supportive and practical assistance to those who have faced crisis situations. Now Tihar is the second actually to adopt in the entire world. Actually, only Pennsylvania State Penitentiary had adopted this. So Tihar is the second after this Pennsylvania prison. So this is good news actually. Tihar jail is the second in the world. So anyway, next one is about Tirupati Varaha. Now the term Varaha is related to pig, right? Actually, Varaha Avatar is one of the incarnations of Lord Vishnu, in which he came as a pig. So same way, we have Tirupati temple dedicated to that Varaha Avatar of Mahavishnu. The same way, it is actually a new crossbreed of pig variety to increase the pork business in India. So it's a new crossbreed pig to set up the pork market. It is developed by many scientists of Tirupati in the Institute and All India Coordinated Research Project, which is a unit of ICAR, Indian Council for Agriculture Research. So yesterday also we have seen one ICAR initiative. We have a seed vault in Ladakh. That is also an initiative by ICAR plus DRDO. Remember that? Okay. So this is a new variety of pig. Now it is a breed between indigenous one and one between Yorkshire. This large white Yorkshire is a pig variety of US. So that US variety plus indigenous pig will be crossbred, and that is given the name Tirupati Varaha. So Tirupati Varaha is related to what? It's a pork industry, or it's a new variety of pig. Okay, it's a small news. Okay, next one is about Earth Overshoot Day. Now today was actually the Earth Overshoot Day. We have the concept called Earth Overshoot Day. Every day it's a kind of a day. Now how it is, what it is, what is Earth Overshoot Day? Now this is defined as a day when the human consumption exceeds the earth's capacity in that particular year to regenerate natural resources. Like if we are saying that this year we have used all the resources that should be produced or that is to be produced in the entire year. For example, 2018, 100 units of resources are produced in the entire world, in the entire planet. And by halfway, by June itself, we are exhausting all the 100 units. So on the day when all the 100 units are exhausted by humans, that day is Earth Overshoot Day. So it is, it's a very good, actually it is done by this global global footmark organization. And recently it came into news because many scientists were discussing about this Earth Overshoot Day. Now it's a day the world completely consumes all the natural resources produced by that, produced that year. So this year they say that all the resources are, all the resources that should, that is to be produced this year are exhausted. So we have to wait till 1.7 times this year to get that much of resource to be replicated or to be regenerated by the earth. So it is calculated by dividing the world biocapacity and dividing it by world ecological footprint. So world ecological footprint is the one that our use is being designated. So our use is designated as world ecological footprint. Footprint is what we do. So we leave a footprint after we use something. So that is ecological footprint, and multiply it by 365. So that will get a value which is equivalent to the resource that is being produced by that year, entire year. So anyway, this is an actually a graph of 1969 to 2017, and they say that on in 2017 we reached 1.7 Earths. So 1.7 Earths means in 2017 the entire human population in the world used the resources that has, that will be produced by 1.7 times the resources. So we are using resources 1.7 times that is produced by the world. For example, 100 units are produced in 2017 and we use 170 units. So what it, what we are producing or what the world is producing, we are using 1.7 times of that. So that is why it lead to, it is leading to resource depletion in different areas. So the resource disparity and distribution of resources is very, you know, critical in this kind of an arena. So that is what Earth Overshoot Day is all about. Next is trade related entrepreneurship development assistance scheme. It is particularly concentrating on women, actually women. It is under the Ministry of MSME and particularly concentrated on economic empowerment of women. How, what are the methods? Trade relating training will be given, information and counseling, extension activities related to trades. Extension activities means how they are given the all the service centers, how they are given the awareness programs and all those, you know, accessibility programs, etc. That is extension activities. Products and services of various things where they can have a self-employment groups are there, self-help groups are there, SHGs. So financial loans are provided by national or financial this institutions, banking institutions, as well as grants will be given by the central government through NGOs, not through NABARD, not through any other panchayat or etc. It will be through NGOs. So NGOs will get a grant from this government, as well as bank will give loans to them to have, what is the ultimate aim? Ultimate aim is to empower the women in entrepreneurship sector. So bring maximum women towards this entrepreneurial area where they can have set up their own self-employment initiatives. That is what. Now there are various other initiatives also, particularly concentrating on women. We have seen many things. Mahila Shakti Kendras are there. There is a Mudra loan. Mudra loan is also particularly concentrating on women, and that too women of you know, lower caste and the scheduled caste and scheduled tribe. So have a good knowledge of that. So ultimate focus is to promote self-employment and income generation activities in non-farm sectors. So that can also be a statement. Non-farm sectors are the major focus. Not if the question comes non-farm sectors only, that is wrong. Major concentration is on non-farm sectors. That's all. So I'm winding up here. See you next time. Have a nice day.